Boom, 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 boom. Shoot you right down. Okay, so you guys asked for it, and today we are building this beautiful medieval castle slash blacksmith's slash tower archer defense thing. It's just awesome. This took me absolutely ages to build. And if you want more builds like this, you're going to have to slap that like button and let me know, because otherwise I'm going to go back to my smaller builds, because I spent hours and hours building this. So I really do hope you enjoy it though. I want to give you guys better content and stuff. This is the back of the building. And yeah, I haven't done the inside. If you want the interior and stuff, we've got some marketplaces down here. So we've got some marketplaces. We've got this beautiful tower going all the way up. Some nice flags. I've made sure I put a lot of detail in this. And we've got a watchtower tower here at the front. And we've got like a guard keep. I'm going to make this into a fighting arena down here where people train. And then it's got like a little building here. And that I'm going to turn into like a food court area. And let's go down. Let's have a look. And obviously we've got an archway here into that bit. We've got a horsey stables. Oh yeah, and then it goes down into here. You can access your horse stables here, and you can get into the fighting arena up here. And then it's got like this walkway up here that leads onto the towers, where the towers are. And this is where you can go to the food court up here. So you can get up here, you can have a lookout, and then I'm going to do the food court in another video if you guys enjoy this and slap the like button. So yeah, and then this looks out onto here. So I've made sure I put a lot of detail in this. And yeah, to all my new subscribers, thank you for subscribing. And yeah, let's get on and build this beast. Let's build this. Welcome to the Dark Ages, my friend. Today, we will be building a massive barracks. You will need at least 10 child slaves to gather all the resources for this bad boy. So let's do this. So this will fit in a 46 by 55. I'm just listening to some epic music to get me in the mood, because I'm going to freestyle this. Yep, I've just made a plan. I kind of know what I'm doing. So, let's do this. So we're going to start off in this corner, which is on the strip of 55. And then we're going to go diagonal. So this is 55, the white line. We're going to be working within it. We're going to count 1, 2, 3 diagonal, 1 out. And then we are going to get an oak. Going to count 1, 2, 3 gaps, and then an oak. And we're going to go to the stone brick. We're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then out 1. And then we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then 7 gap. And then on the 8th, 1, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Grab our oak. We're going to have 1 space there. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces. An oak, a space, an oak. So this is going to be the doorway into the place. I'm thinking. I'm going to have an extra tower here. So we're going to go back from here. Going to get a stone brick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then counting from this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You guessed it. 7 by 7. So I'll just fly up so you can take a look what we've got so far. Right. So now we're going to go back from this square. Facing out, we're gonna go 1, 1 either side, and then we're gonna count 1, 2, 3 gaps, 1, and then 1, 2, 3 gaps, 1 here. So from this oak here, this one, we are gonna count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with this stone brick, and we're gonna get our oak, 1, 1, 2, 3 gaps, 1. So just pause at any time if I'm going too fast, because I'm going to have to get through this. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 gaps. 1, 2, 3 gaps. 1, 2, 3 gaps. So we've got that so far. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then from this oak here, I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 gaps. 1, 2, 3 gaps. It should be all in line with these. Perfect. So at the back of this second row, we're going to just run a line of the stone going all the way until we meet there. So at the side of this end oak now, this end oak here, we're going to put 1, And then we're going to count diagonal, 1, 2, diagonal again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, diagonal up, 1, 2, diagonal up, 1. So we should have that shape so far. Now along this back wall, we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then out by 1, 2, 3. 1, 2 to the side, and then just make a kind of little rectangle. And start again, 1, 2. All the way back to a rectangle, 1, 2, all the way back to a rectangle. So starting from this block here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and then 1, 2, 3, so there should be 4 on this line altogether. 1, 2, rectangle, 1, 2, rectangle, 1, 2, rectangle. So it should be the same, should be all symmetric. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Diagonal 1, diagonal this way, 1, 2, diagonal again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we should have that. Perfect. So we're going to count 1, 2, and then we're going to get an oak for here, because it's going to be combined within the wall. Diagonal again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, and it should meet up. So along this back wall where we've got this oak, where we started, we're going to count 1, 2, 3 gaps, 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 and it should all join in. And now there's going to be a gap of 3 in between each one. So just pause the video. So you should have 3 gaps in between each. So 3 gaps there, 3 gaps there, 3 gaps there, 3 gaps there. You get the idea. Perfect. Okay. So at the front here, where I said the front entrance is, we're going to start around this area. So it's going to be a doming arch here, I think. I think I'm going to do an arch there. But for this side, we're going to go to the side. We're going to count from this block here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. One out, one gap, one out, one gap, one gap. So there should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 altogether. And then in between here, we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1. And there should be a 1, 2, 3 gap there. Okay, so we've got that so far. So we're going to go around to this side here, where we've got these 4 pillars. So we're going to start with a stone from this one. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then make that into a rectangle there. And then we're going to do this long strip that goes all the way up here. So we're just going to drag it all the way along until it meets the other side. So it should join on this corner here, as you can see. So it should go all the way along and it should meet just next to this one here. So we're going to build those circles up. I've got this little bit as well. So this bit here, where we've got the 4 things here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 even, we're going to go out, 1, 2, 3, 4, turn round, count from this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, should meet the back wall. Okay, so this is within the courtyard here. So we're going to go along this side, we're going to grab our oak. Should be a 3 gap here. Gonna go 1, 1, 2, 3 gap, 1, 1, 2 gap, 1, 1, 2, 3 gap, 1, 1 gap, 1, 1, 2, 3 gaps, 1. Perfect. And then we've got to do these circles within here. So we're gonna do it either side. So we're gonna have a 1 gap all along that wall, and then we're gonna count 5 here. 1, 5 back, 1, 5. 1, 5, 1. So we've got a circle there. It should look like that. It should have all those gaps. So just pause the video, take a look. We're going to do the same at the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we should have that 5 gap at the back there. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Right. Okay, so now we can start building up the main foundation. So I'm going to do it at the back here. So this big circle, or squished circle, I don't know what they're called. Oblong? I don't know. I don't have a clue, man. I don't know shapes. I just build, you know? So, highwood. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're going to bring all these up to 7. So this going around here, this 2, 1, this big long strip going all the way across to the other side. And then we're just going to miss this little bit here. Bring this up, this all the way around. So we should be leaving the circles in the middle. We'll do those after. And then this going all the way along at the back. And we're going to raise it up 7. I'm going to speed all this up. So all the way along the back here. 1, 1, 2. And then this part here. So I'm going to raise this up by 7 altogether. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 from the ground. Okay, so once you've done that, we are going to raise these up to the same level. This big circle thing. It's all going to be raised up to 7 altogether. So this is going to be raised. All these are going to be raised. And we're going to be taking stuff out of this. We're going to be taking bricks out of this, but I'm doing the main foundation, so I'll speed this up for getting the circles up to 7. Okay, you should have both circles up now. What we're going to do is from... Right, I'll just show you. This is the front. So to the right-hand side here, we're going to bring this up all together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bring all these back ones up to 5. Right, okay. So now we're going to put... 2 stones on top so it kind of joins in. And now for along here, we're just going to grab the slab of the oak. Going to bring it all the way across and then should overlap by 1 there. I'm going to go a second time all the way across. And we're going to actually place 1 on top here. And then we're just going to go down in increments of 2. Check me out. I just made that word up now. I think it works. Go all the way across. Oh, beautiful. Well, I'll take some of this. It'd be speedier. But you guys can just pause it. Right. Okay. All the way across there. And then we'll double this up again. I don't know what this bit is. Maybe an outside market or something. Okay, so that's gone down. And then we can... go under and then under again. So we're killing it round. So this will go all the way across and then it goes down an extra 1 here. And this is just so it covers up what we've got underneath. So we're going to raise these up by 1, 2, and then we're just going to put a slab underneath there. And then we can actually put an extra 1 there. 1, 2, 1. Like that. So 1, 1, 1 all the way across. I don't need to speed this bit up. Put 1 on each and then we are just gonna do the same thing that we've done. 1 there, 1, 2, 1. 1, 1, 2, 1. Right, so now we've got that outside bit. That's gonna look nice. We can actually trim that up and stuff a bit later. We are going to raise this castle wall up to the same level as this. So this will be going all the way across as well. And yeah, bring everything up to 7. So all these ones around here, this is going to be up to 7. You can trim this as well across the bottom. This is going to be like a gateway where there's going to be an archway. This is going to be up to 7. We're going to leave these outside walls here. This is going to go all the way around to 7. This curling round here as well. And it's just going to be raised up and filled completely in. So I'll speed this up. Okay, once we've got that up, it should look like this. Should have this at the side. Looking nice and tasty, mate. And we're going to bring this up an extra 1. But first, on the inside of here, we're just going to trim this all in. So this is all going to be with the slab of the oak. You can use full blocks as well, I guess, but I don't know. I'm going to go all the way around and just fill all this space in with the slab. And then we can bring these up by an extra 1, this circle on the inside. and then we're going to work on an outside kind of wall. Okay, so once we've done that, we should have all this filled in and we should have those brought up a little bit. So we're going to work on this front bit here. I'm going to try and give this some sort of arch. So I'm going to count 1, 2. 1, 2 at the other side going up. 1, 1. Maybe 1 again. 1, 1. I'll just try this out. Yeah, that looks all right. And then we're going to fatten this bit up. Get this on the inside. And then these two across here. Okay. So now what we are going to do is, let's see. I kind of want this going across. Okay, so we're going to fill this going across here, all the way across. And we're going to fill this whole top bit in with the oak slabs. So I'll speed this up. Okay, so once we've done that, we should have that all filled in. What we're going to do is we're going to fill this with the stone on the inside. And what I'm wanting to do is start from here, one either side, bring this up to the top until it meets here. We're going to have to put a slab there. Bring this up, slab there. Okay, so now we're going to go underneath like this and then put an extra one there. Put a stair underneath here and here. And then we're going to put one at the bottom here and here. Very nice. And then we're just going to put one out like this, another one out. Perfection. Right, okay. We're going to put one either side here, bring these up, and we're going to actually put one out. Then we'll get our slab, putting all the way across, just thickening that baby up, looking nice. We'll work some more on the inside, but we can actually bring these out an extra one, because this is going to be within a building, so it's going to be a building kind of here. Okay, so we're going to start with this building on top. So we put that out here, and then we're going to go 1, 2, 3 gaps, 1, 2, 3 gaps. An extra one, 1, 2, 3 gaps there. Gonna do 1, 2 like we've done over there. So 1, 2, 3 gaps should be in line with that one. And we're working it on along this oak line. 1, 2, 3 gaps. 1, 2, 3 gaps in between. Put this one here. And then can we do a 1, 2, 3 gap here? 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Perfect. And then that's going to lead on to this bit. I might do a walkway going up onto that. Maybe. Because there's going to be a wall there. Okay, so starting from this corner, we're going to drag this all the way across to the other side. And we're going to do 3 lines. 1, 2, 3. And then, in fact, for this wall here, I'm going to curl it round. And then curl it around this way. Take this out so this is part of the wall. Might actually put that one as a full block. And then we're going to have a walkway up here. Maybe 3. So there should be 2 stairs there. Face these down. We're going to grab the spruce. Bring it up to this point. Bring it all the way across and round. Just to there for now. Okay, so we're going to bring these up an extra 1, 2, so it'd be 3 altogether. In fact, 4, and then we can join them like this. So it'd be from the ground 1, 2, 3, 4. Bring this all down, bring this up as well. Bring these up, and you guessed it, put it all the way around. Right, so we come around to this side, 1, 2, 3, bring that up, 1, 2, 3, bring that up. Okay, so now for these bits, we're going to join it onto the roof here. Should join in there. ideal. That's ideal. Okay, so now we've got that, we're going to work on some kind of form of detail here. So we're going to get this here. And then we're going to put it in between here. We're going to have this bit as a doorway here, so we can leave that bit. Put stone across, upside downstairs, within this. Like there. And then even underneath here as well. Right, so now what we are going to do on these corners here, we're going to put a full block here and we're going to fill this in with the white wool. Fill it in here as well at the front. And for these side bits, we're going to have some windows here. So we're going to fill these either side and we're going to have some panes filled in the middle there. But for now, we're just going to leave it. So one full strip for there. Don't destroy your building because that's counterproductive. Put one either side here, one either side here, fill this beauty in, fill these two, kind of guessed it. Okay, so now I want to kind of add some depth into there. Right, so now what we are going to do, we're going to put a full block and then we're going to place a cobblestone wall on every single bit where there's a log, so like that. Couldn't think of the word then. That's embarrassing. Right, so I'll do all the way around. Even with the doorway at the other side, it's just gonna have one of these and then a cobblestone. Okay, so as you can see, we've got this all the way around. And what I'm gonna do is gonna place a spruce on top of all of them. And then we're gonna place this. Might run this going all the way around. So I'll speed this up. Right, so it should go all the way around and meet this part of the roof and then just carry on and then put them all in. So I'll speed it up again. Okay, so once we've got that bit, we are going to get some oak stairs. And then we're going to work on it like this. So we're going to go all the way across. And then at this side, it's going to go all the way across. And we're just going to keep on doing this until it meets in the middle. So I'm going to speed this bit up. Okay, you should have something like this. We haven't got the top yet, but we will do that. If you just want to save on resources, you can just put the one out. But I'm going to put it all the way through for now. So all the way through to the other side. And then we're going to work on where we're going to put these. So this is going to go up. And we're going to put one every other one, so it should go up. And then we're gonna extend the roof a little bit extra, but I just kind of wanted to get this flat detail in first. So we've got that so far, and same here. So one there, one there. It's gonna be the same as the other side, so it should all meet up. This is just so we can have our white blocks in the middle, so it's either side there. Right, so now we're gonna fill the rest of it in with the white wool. So get this bit there, up to there. Right, so fill all those in with white wool, that the other side, and then we're going to extend this roof out by an extra one. And then we're just going to put ladders underneath, or stairs even. So I'm going to speed this up. Okay, so once you're done, you should have this on both sides. So on the other side here as well, it's overhanging by one and you've got those stairs going up the side. So we're going to bring this out by another one and this out by another one. So we're going to get our stairs facing either side out here. We're going to bring it out by one and then we're going to curl it up and out like that. We're going to do the same here. So one facing out, I'm going to turn around, place one down, and then aim at the top of it and shoot it out like that. And then we're just going to run a strip going all the way along here with the oak. Okay, so that's nice so far. What we can do actually is we can take two out here. We can even you know, add a little detail here as well. And we can get some spruce going up to the top. We can even have... We can leave it like that, I guess. That's nice. Just to add a little bit extra. And we can do the same at the other side, so take out two here. You don't have to add these bits in, it's just kind of extra for people wanting a little extra detail and stuff, so... Yeah, and then now I'm just going to fill in all the glass going all the way around, so I'll speed this up. You can use whatever you like. You can use panes or you can use blocks if you're in Minecraft Pocket Edition, because I know they don't join to them. Right, you should have that going all the way around, so you should have all those window panes in at the front here. You can fill these and make these into windows as well. At the front as well, you can add this little bit. Get your cobblestone, and then you can get maybe this going like this. So you've got a bit more of an archway there. And if you don't like that, let's see. Leave it like that, and then just get one facing out. You could maybe have that, or you could just leave it bare. I'm going to leave it bare there, but I'll leave those stairs there and put that across. Which is alright. That's nice. Right, okay. Let's have a little look away. That's looking okay. I kind of like that so far. We're going to have those gates there. We're going to have this tower, right. So this tower here is going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Just the same as everything else. We're going to box this off, and I think I'm actually going to take detail out of this. So across there, well, we'll box this off first, and then we'll see what we can do with it. Right, so take these bottom bits out, because I'm going to do it so you can't get into this bit. But... I'm kind of inclined to do this. Right, get the cobblestone. We can leave the outside rim there that's in the floor. You can put that in the floor there. So we're going to build this on the inside here. And we're going to bring this up to the same level and kind of box it off within the box. And then we've got some back wall to kind of detail in, because I'm going to be putting a lot more of this into the build a bit later on, but I might as well start getting some in now. Just to add those details in. And you'll find out I'll be taking like bits out in places, and I'm giving you the client kind of a clean version first, and then afterwards what I usually do is like tidy it up or mess it up even. Just kind of like controlled mess. So it kind of like looks like it's been destroyed in areas and stuff. It just makes it look a hell of a lot better. So we're gonna get this trim going across here. And across here, then on the inside, and here. Let's see. Now I kind of want to bring it up so we face upwards this time, so it's kind of giving a base towards the bottom of the tower. And right, so now let's get one in each corner here, and then face another one out like this, so you should have that shape, and then aim at the bottom here with your stair, and there you should have something like that. And then what we can do is we can add the oak log in the middle. As you can see, it just adds that little bit of detail in. We can go around adding some more detail in, like here and here, and maybe a full block here, you know, something like that. Just kind of adds more detail to it. So I'll repeat it once more time. I can't speak, and we do it all the way around. So do it for this one, there and there in each corner, making your oval, and then aim at the bottom there with your stair, and aim at the top for the bottom. Perfect. Then we get our oak, and we get one at the top of the oak and the bottom of the oak, and then get two slabs filling in there. So I'll speed it up for the rest of them. Okay, so once we've done that, I'm going to add a little bit of detail into this by counting up 1, 2, and then 1, 1 out. 1, 2, 1 on top of each one. We can leave it for that because it's kind of going to be the front gate area. One, two, one out like that. It's just adding more dimension into the build. And it just, yeah, makes it look a hell of a lot better. And it looks more supported at the bottom because it's going to go up from the top. We can leave those ones because they're going to come up. Right, so what we are going to do now is we're going to start on top of here. We're going to count up by two. And then we're going to go along here. Drag it all the way along. All the way along. Put one down. And then we're going to put one out like this. All the way around. One out like that. I don't think it should affect the other wall. I'm not sure yet. But like this wall. Oh no. It's totally out of the way. So we're going to bring these up. We're going to put one either side. We're going to keep in with the white and striped theme with the oak. So altogether, I think 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So altogether, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we're going to close it off and put it out like this. So just as we've done in, at the bottom, we're going to do this in each corner. So we're going to need our white wool once we've done this bit. This go all the way around, that's facing out. That there, that's going to go up to the top. That's up to the top. Up to the top, up to the top. So I'll speed it up, we're going to fill in all the rest with white wool. Okay, so once we've done that, we're going to put place one underneath, like this, in fact. One underneath, one down like this. We'll place one, two oak down. We're going to join this at this point. It's just an excuse to join that. And then at the top here, for these bits, we can actually join on so I can get these ones here. So as you can see, over and under. Hell yeah. Love it when a plan comes together. Put this underneath here and then oak log. For these ones, these can come all the way up to past this bit here. And then we can do the same. Just an excuse to join it on. And it doesn't matter if it's not, you know, equal and stuff. I'm going to bring that up as well. And then this bit here, over, under, over, oak log. So you can kind of mess around with different dimensions with it and it should still work. Because when you start messing it up, if you look around, like if you look around like that, even that doesn't look out of place because there's going to be another maybe marketplace there or training area. So it doesn't matter, right? So we've got that there. This is going to come up to the same level as this. So this is kind of the gateway into the place. And then we can place one on top of each. That can go all the way to meet that wall there. In fact, we can just put it across the top. Joining on that bit. Let's put this across here and one in there. One in there as well. We can join it like that there. And let's see. For this bit, I kind of want to put some spruce fence going in there and then spruce fence going all the way down here and here. We can put it across the top as well there. Fill this bit in here. Very nice. We can put these on the outside as well. Just to add to that. We can drag this around so it blends in there. In fact, no, I don't want to do that for the bottom. I kind of want to do a different block altogether to distinguish the fact that it's kind of the gateway. Yeah, that's perfect. Perfection within one bottle. We can pull out a little bit here and we can fill this in with that. That's nice there. We can take some chips out of it and stuff. We can do the same here, actually. One at the bottom. One, two, three. Because I think there's three here, making it kind of equal there. But for this side, we'll bring the stone going up to the top. And maybe that going there. And then as we have done with the other side, just so it kind of meets up and it blends in there. And then we can put another window here then. One there. Perfect. Yeah, that's looking nice. It's looking tasty, mate. It's looking tasty. Right, so got that out so far. And I kind of want to do some more across that trim. Just to kind of give more depth and definition away from just that being flat. So we can put that across here. As you can see, it just separates the wood from the stone a little bit better. And it makes it look top notch, top class. Okay, we can leave that fairly plain. Because I think the plain looks quite good anyway. And then for this bit, I am going to use the polished andesite. We'll put one on each. Here. I kind of want to do this so it's facing out. So that's not bare. Put the oak one, two, three, maybe. Yeah, one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. And then we're going to get the stairs facing under like this. So it's kind of like an under arch. And then face it out and out, 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 out. That's not out, that's under. Out, out, out. Let's have a look at this. Okay, and then we place another block in the middle of each one. And grab our oak, bring it up to the same level. One, two, three even. Perfect. And I'm gonna get a trim going all the way around here. And let's see. So we can do this completely different, this one, because it's kind of out of the way. And we're gonna grab our cobblestone wall, cobble. And like a turkey. And then we're gonna place these. We can do it up to the top, give you a... So you don't have to have those two cobbles like that. You can just have it placed up to the top there, which is fine there. Put it for each one. It's going to be a long tutorial, guys, but hopefully it's worth it. This is why I do the smaller ones, because sometimes these take a very long time to do these as a tutorial. It's a lot of thinking involved. Okay, so now we are going to work on some kind of roof, some kind of dimension of a roof. So we're going to grab the oak planks and the oak slabs, and we're going to go out one, two, three, out one, two, three, out one, two, three, out one, two, three. So now we can place one, two on there, and then we can do this. We're going to actually add some more, but that's fine. We can actually do five and then a diagonal. Would that be better? Yeah, we can do five and a diagonal. So five altogether. So turn these threes into a five and then just place one block. One block on there and just move it so it's either side. So one block, either side like that. And then we put one down like here. Let's go to these areas here. Underneath here, we can just put that going all the way across. So start from here, so you can get three diagonals, one, two, three, four, five across here. So we just follow in this five pattern. Five there. Right, let's go back. Right, okay, so now we're going to bring this up. So we're going to put five across here, another five, three, one. One, two, three, four, five, One, two, three, four, five across the same. Three, one. One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. Three, one. It's a good way to build it up like this. And then you can always take chunks out. So, as you can see, puts up like that. And then we can put one, two, three like that. Yeah. One, two, three, four blocks. One. One, two, three, one. I think this defines the good builders from the bad builders, the roofs. How they can blend the roof. So now we're going to go one, one, one. There's so much you can do with roofs. They're very, very versatile when it comes to stuff like this. And there's a lot of detail you can, a lot of time and detail you can spend on it. So now what we're going to do from the corner, one, two, three. Corner one, two, three. Corner one, two, three. Corner one, one, whoa, 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 one, two, three. Keep looking out. Yeah, that's okay so far. So we're going to join this across here and turn it into kind of a square. This is just to make it easier for you guys, and then we can replace one here. Nice. And then we're going to go like this, cross in the middle, build this cross up, one, two, one, two, here, one, two, one, two, three, four. Now we can add some more detail. We're going to put one here, going all the way around, and then we're going to grab our stairs of the oak. We're going to do this. Now we can add more detail into this. This is if you want it basic. Obviously we're going to have to do something with this. We'll put stairs out like this. And then what we can do is grab that, and we can grab the spruce fence. So one either side here, bring this up to the two. And then we can put one on top and then count up one, two, three, four. And then we can put a stone on top. We can make a flag on that at a later date. Okay, so now if you want more detail into the roof, which not necessarily needed, but we can do. So where the step goes down, you want to take out these two. So these two steps. All the way around. Then we're going to take out from here. As you can see there. So it should be a stair, not that level, this next level here. I mean, I can spend hours just doing roofs because they're quite enjoyable. Just what sort of different patterns you can get out of it. So for this one, this bottom one here, you can shape it here as well. So we can take these out. You don't have to do this bit, you can just wait along. I forgot that little bit there. Take these out here, perfect. And then you can actually take some out of this as well. For these corner bits. I could spend all day. This is kind of why I don't do detailed builds, because it's restricted. Because I feel like, oh sugar, I need to hurry up. Okay, so on this bit where you've got the stair going down, we're gonna put two out like this. All the way along. And then what we can do is we can add this in here just to separate those bits. Okay, and then we can put this in just to start to add some color into your roofs and stuff. So it's more grand at the top, as you can see. Then we can add more in here. And we can use these as spines. They'd usually have on the top of a roof. And then you can just have one of these on top of each one. There we go. Needs a spine there. And here. Okay. And then you can start adding more like underneath here at the bottom of that spine. So it's okay to just kind of mix and match your roofs so they kind of, as you can see, just starts to bring a hell of a lot more detail into it. I mean, if you wanted like a bit here, because that's kind of one of the main focuses, so we can just put that to there and then put a stair here. So repeat for the other side, just so you don't get confused. So place it down on that one, it'll go up. So take this one out of the middle, put one there. You put a slab either side, and then you just place down on there. And you get that sort of pattern. And then you can put a stair on top of there with a slab coming out. So much you can do with roofs, it's unreal. I could spend a whole tutorial just doing like a roof. So there, either side, that going down, that going down. One stair there, that, and then this side. Usually I'd probably be building like this, just like speeding up. Because after I've done it once, I don't really need to think about it. But there we go, that's an okay roof. And let's get this underneath here. We'll get a stair going underneath here, underneath each point. It's about 15 minutes just on one roof. God damn it. That's a lot of roof time. We'll put this underneath here to add some extra. And then we can then use that as kind of a bottom lay to hold a support beam, so we can get a support beam coming up here as well, because the roof probably wouldn't hold by itself if it had all that hanging off it, so you'd probably put extra support. Let's see. So yeah, this is kind of not usable. It's not really one of those efficient builds, but it just kind of, it looks a lot better than you'd usually have for a build. Right, so underneath these points here, we can put these little archways. We'll just add to it. So from the inside, we can just do this. Underneath each one. Yeah, and let me know if this helps you improve your building skills and stuff, because I always like hearing from you guys. Awesome. So we'll fill this all the way across. You'd probably have some kind of support beam coming through the top here to support the main structure of the roof. You'd maybe have some more in medieval times for your top paneling. That's nice. We can actually put a level on here. Let's see. We need a way to actually get into this guard roof, so I'll do that after. I'm kind of going to just have a pull coming up. We might even have a staircase coming round from this side, maybe into this panel. Well, I don't know yet, but that is okay so far. Kind of like it, looks nice. Across here as well, if you want to make it a bit grander, I tend to go off and add detail for some weird reason. So we can put one either side here, we can put one either side here. And then we can put 1, 2, 3. It'd be a bit more of a grand barracks. But I just think adding details like this, it just separates your build from a lot of other medieval builds. I kind of like to make mine like, I don't know. A good guy would have come along and just gone, yeah, that needs some bushes there. It needs some bushes there to make that look nice. Get it trimmed up nice. We'll put some either side here, just so it looks a bit less bare. Just adding that green in, it really does make your build, separates it, make it look a hell of a lot better. And obviously when you start adding more detail into it, it's gonna look awesome. Okay, so we've got that bit done, and yeah, we're gonna build this bit up now. Let's get rid of all that. We're gonna bring all these all the way to the other side, and it's going to be up to 7, the same height as everything else, and this is going to come up as well. and join there. That's going to join there. And we're going to definitely need some archways building into this. Build that up as well. In fact, we'll fill it all in and then we can do it later. So I'll speed it up, fill that full thing in, and that full thing in. Okay, so once you've done that, we're going to fill this in now. This panel here. Going to go across. Let's fill this bit in. And yeah, we're going to start building up some form of a castle wall. Or wall of some form. But at this side as well, the left-hand side, we're going to bring these up and we're going to do kind of the same as what we did to the other side. So from the ground, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I think I might actually do a trim. Want to see where it ends here. Yeah. So from here, we're going to bring it all the way around. And it should stop at that castle wall there. And we can bring these all the way up. Okay, so we'll have this going across here, and then I'm gonna have to end it there, in fact there, and we're gonna bring these up by 1, 2, 3 all together. 1, 2, 3, that was 4 bad blocks. 1, 2, 1, 2, and then we're gonna put a full block here of the oak. And then we're going to overlap here. To bring this all the way across to there so it meets up. And then we can fill this bit in now. One overhanging. And this would go up. And then that'll be 2 at the top. So 2 at the top here. We can bring it all the way to the other side actually. So it joins onto that bit. Bring this going all the way across and kind of end here. I think would be quite good. We can add an extra 3. 1, 2, 3. And then it goes to this point here. Goes up and then fill that in. We want an extra overhang there. Make it look a little bit better. Okay, that's nice. Kind of like that. I don't know how I'm going to take a picture of this because this is pretty badass. Badass, mother trucker. Right, so fill this, I'm going to fill it up by 2. And so I can have a bit there. I want that facing out, then 1, 2. Get some spikes actually. Okay, let's see. 1, 1, 1. I'll see if this works. If it doesn't, yeah, perfect. Right, so now that's going on either side. And then we're going to add to this 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Just fill it all the way along. God damn it. Okay, that's looking nice. That's looking nice. Well, that needs to come to that. And inside here, we can actually do this. But we can actually do this instead. Wait. If we do it on the inside here, like that, put that across, we'll have that into a spike as well. 1, 1, 2. And then we can put these underneath like this. Just to kind of give it a little bit better trim for the castle wall. That's looking nice. Can keep that simple. For these bits now, this is where it gets a little bit complicated of how I'm gonna do it. Okay, so that's out like that. Maybe put the one out there. 1, 2, 3. That's okay there. Yeah, I can live with that. And then that's either side. So it's the same as that one. So you've got one space there. And then that out just like that. Okay, so hopefully this will work now. I'm not sure if I've got the right dimensions. So we're having one space in between each one. Come on, come on, bro. Perfect. There we go. I've done my dimensions correctly. It's always a good sign. And we're gonna do this out. Yeah. Perfect. Oh, that's awesome. That is wicked. Put this across. I want to see how I've done this. Because I did that down. Now we can do this to put extra emphasis on these spikes here. Putting it out. Let's put it underneath and out. Yeah, I can live with that. I can live with the extra little bit. Put it out like this and out. This bit here, I'm thinking of doing this. Out, out, out. So we've got that corner, but at the same time, it's one of those awkward corners. That's to there. That's that two out like that. We can kind of leave it and do something like this. We'll join it on. Because it's kind of a funny one, it's difficult. But we can just leave it as a one and just have a one there like that, which is fine. That's totally fine. Get that. So we double these up. I'll speed it up and put these underneath as well. Okay, so once we've done that all the way along, it should look like that, looking nice. We're gonna add more detail into that wall later. And let's see how we've done this one. I think I start from here. Here. Can actually do this like this. I want to do it different on this side. Which that's fine. Yeah, put it to there. Perfect. Get that across there, putting them on top of each one. And then do the same as what we've done at the other side for this one. Which is placing 1, 2. Okay. So we go like this, 1, 1 underneath, 1, 2. Extend these by 2. And then out with this bit, which is the 2 mark. So the 2 mark there. So miss that one, and then the 2, 1, 2. For this bit, we can just put the 1 there. And as we've done at the other side, we just put there and there. So we've got something quite nice shaping there. Damn fool. So I've got this lower at this side for some reason, but that's fine. That is cool, man. Because I kind of like it low there. In fact, yeah, we'll work with that. Depending on how you've done it, maybe you've done it all the way around like that. I think actually I'm going to bring up this height here. At least here. I want to leave it low at the other side because I kind of like how it's turned out. Sometimes accidents work out for the best. There, that going across there. And then I can have a railing going across there, which means I can extend this bit out. Which I am cool with. I am cool with that. That going to there, maybe put a stair in here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And then we can get our fence and put it across here. We can have a full block there and then connect this bit on. There. I'll just put that back. That's all right. I'm going to put these back up here. So obviously, just these little spaces here that I've done wrong, which is fine. I'll just do that, that, and then just extend it. I was wondering why there. That could have been a disaster. Luckily, I've got my keen eyes on me. Right, so we've got that. That's looking nice. And yeah, in between each one of these, we can put this and this going across as well. In fact, we did it from the inside, which it doesn't matter about this side because you're not going to kind of see that bit. But if you want to do the same, then yeah, you're welcome to do that. So this going all the way across, I'll speed it up to the other side. Once you've done that, we'll go out now. Okay, perfect. So now what we are going to do for this bit, we're going to raise this to the top up here. I'm going to square it off. And then this is going to go up. It's kind of like, I'm not sure about this bit. This is just to add detail, I guess, into the wall, making it look less plain. So we have something like that. And then for these bits, I'm going to place these down. That going in there, and then out by two. There we go. Perfect. So we're going to do the same at the other side. Bring this up to here, level. Bring it up. Around. Around like a fat butt. Square this off here. Here and here. Whoa, 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 man. We can actually take some out and make it part of the castle wall, so you can like remove these bits inside. And then we can remove a place so you can actually get into the castle. We can work with that. I mean, if you want more of an archway. You get an archway, which if you just stick a thing there, just gives it a little arch. What did I do for this bit? Oh, sugar. This bit here. Then put them down facing, and then out and out again. Okay, so once we've got those sides, they're both looking the same. Now we can add an extra stone up. Give some more dimension on the bottom. Okay, and we can actually do this side as well, up to there. And around here. Yeah, once we've got some bush and we've trimmed up this wall a little bit better, it's gonna look awesome. Because as soon as you start taking blocks out and making it a little bit more kind of run down and stuff, you can even have an archway here. If you wanted an archway into the back of the building, I'd count one, two on the third one. One, two on the third one. We can count up three, four. And then let's see how this would work out. Maybe remove that. And could just have it going up to the top, actually. Have it going up to the top there. Fit that on there. And then the archway, I'll probably put one, two there. One, two. And that at the top. Blend that across the top, and then yeah, you can just pick out this bit here. And if you do the same on the inside as well, it'd make it look good. Let's see. So you just put these underneath, making sure it's all matching up. Put this in. There we go. It's all right. And then yeah, as I've done inside the other one, so remove these. Take it out the middle. So three high and three wide, making sure you've got one either side. Take one out and just place a half block in there. So that's another way to get into the barracks, which is alright. Let's see. I'll put this extended out and this along here. Very nice. Very nice, bros. And then this going across here. I kind of want to cover that bit up so we can extend this bit and accentuate that arch by adding some dimension. Okay, I kind of like that at the back. That's nice. Oh, I love it when a plan comes together. In fact, we'll add some bush now. Now, you can make this as messy as you like. If you want it nice and neat, I'd just do something like this. Just get it nice and trimmed round. Maybe this is not destroyed, you know. But if you want it a bit messier, you can just have it dragging up the wall and stuff, you know. whichever you prefer, but I'm going to keep it the tidy way for now. And if you want to start adding detail to it as well, I would use the mossy brick and use the stone brick stairs as well, so, and the crack brick. So take it out, you can take places out and maybe put, you know, like little bits in here that's where it's cracked and stuff. Even holes in it where you put your stairs, that way you could have some holes and yeah, just mix it up a little bit. There'd be more wear and tear on these kind of corner bits. Do you know what I mean? Looks pretty beastly. So we can leave that there. We're going to have the two towers there. We can leave that plain. We've got our nice front there. Definitely going to have to do another tutorial for the insides, I think. Because, yeah, it's going to take a long, long time. I'm going to put another archway here. And right, so we'll get some stone brick. I might get some cobblestone and these to add more detail. I'm definitely going to need some oak. And, Seabiscuit. Okay, so we're going to bring this all the way to the top so it meets with this one. Will this one meet with another one? No, so we're not going to put that one to the top because it'll just look funny otherwise. So we'll get this going across here. Can actually bring that out, doesn't matter. Bring that out around there, this going around here. Join it on a little bit extra. Can bring this wall up, put one each time. We can make it simple on the inside. Most of the castle defenses would be on the outside, so the inside you don't need too much. I'd say something like just a one or something would be all right. We'll definitely have a way to get up. I think I'm gonna have some stairs coming up from here. So we'll remove these blocks and we'll have this three here. One either side there. So I have this coming down from here, which is, so you should have one from this corner here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then cobblestone. And then we've got the three staircase going down here. So I'll speed it up so it goes down to the ground. Okay, so once you've done the staircase there, what we're going to do, we're going to bring these up. And it's going to go across here. So they're up by three. Go up across here. And out. And then we're going to bring this one up. This is going to go across here. I want a kind of another doorway into it. Get a two doorway going underneath here. Into the place. And then we can kind of do a doorway on the inside as well, but I'm going to leave that for the interior. Right, let's bring these up. Bring it up to the same height as that one on the corner. Bring this one up to the same height. 1, 2, 3, 4 on top. So it's 5 altogether. And then for these bits, we'll put some stone bits on each place. So you've kind of got your bit coming up. And then that's going underneath there, so it should be resting on there and there. In fact, we can bring these up from here. I kind of want to bring this up and then have this as a log here. And then a kind of like three here. Bring this log to this and we can kind of have like an overlook. Let's see. Let's get this. So bring it out, cone it round. Oh my god. How did he do it? Let's get oak planks. Sugar. Put this across. Going round. And then we've pretty much just got the two towers to do. Pardon the pun. Lord of the Rings. No, was that a pun? I don't know. Probably not. Been watching too much Little Britain. Pardon the pun. And then once we've done that, I'm going to put one on this side. and then we're gonna go up and along. I'm gonna keep this a tiny small one. Fill that bit in. Fill it in, and then 1, 2, 3 into a cross, and then 1. Does that look nice? I don't know. Get these, rid of these two, put that there. Maybe, baby. I don't know. Let's have a little look. Yeah, that should do. I don't know why that's there. I don't like the look of you. Okay, so underneath here, we can trim this up. And then we can actually put a light there or whatever. But it's medieval times, so we are going to have some normal, you know, like lanterns and stuff. So we're going to, I'm going to put these archways underneath each one. I'm going to see how this works out. That's under there. That's under there. And then fill that bit in there. Okay, yeah, kind of like that. And then I want to add some more detail by doing this instead. That there. And get some lanterns on these as well, which might make it look quite nice. Okay, from this staircase here, we're going to have these supports going up to the top to meet here, which looks nice. And let's have a look at a distance. That's okay. One kind of these like little training areas. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 maybe on there, on that one. That's going around. Okay. Yeah, so I'm going to put this going across at this point. So it should go all the way across here and rest on top. And we can actually walk along the top of it as well. So it's going to overlap by this much. So it should be in line with these maybe. Whoa. Okay. So this is going to go all the way across and meet here. And then all the way across the top of here. We can actually fill this bit in. So it kind of fills in with the roof. Mixes in a little bit. I'll speed it up, just filling the top of this in. Okay, so once we've done that, we are going to bring this pillar up. And then I kind of want to put it down a bit. Put it down a bit, bring it across, and I want a pole coming through here to this point here, which is fine. It just levels it up, and you can see how you can make it a lot different. You can put one there and there. Okay, it being at different levels, maybe have this. We're gonna need some light, definitely, so you guys can see. But yeah, I'm going to leave that for now because I'm going to work on more stuff around here. Could be doing marketplaces and stuff. These bits here, I want you to bring them to the top. Part one, and then just place this on top. And we're going to put that there. So bring it to the top. We're going to have a stair in there. 1, 2, 3. So altogether, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then a stair on top of each one. Take it out of here so it rests nicely, and then put an upside down stair here, maybe put some across here, but we could have an archway there as well into the building, so we can have that there, and then one there, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Have the archway kind of there. Think that'd be a better one. Yeah. Build all this out here. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to do another video because this is probably quite long as it is. And then double this up so it kind of. There we go. That's a perfect arch. Gonna have to do more in that one. This one, I mean, you can make the roof more fat and stuff. I mean, you can put it along this edge as well. two here, and then an extra one. But you don't have to do this. It's just kind of just to add a little bit extra. And that's so far, that's nice. Maybe we could get a little gateway here. And then obviously we're going to do the flooring as well. But I think so far that's all right for that little bit. And we'll just work on the towers and call it a day for this video, I think. But yeah, so far I'm quite proud of it. We're going to have to add some more stuff in. I mean, you can even block off fences inside here because it'd be more of the inside of the place. Could put some stairs down here as well. Let's see. So it's level with there. And then we can get this going all the way across. Can kind of level this off there. Up to there. I don't know, you could put a pillar there or something. It's this bit here, that goes onto there. This bit, right. Okay, we need something around this bit. We can actually just do fence around this bit as well. But we can also just put some of these. That'll be a full one. There, full one. And then something like this, you know. We can have that as a full one as well. Don't like that better though. Can take it off there, that corner. That's fine. That's looking okay. And you just see. Doesn't have to be symmetrical. If you don't want that bit there, you can just take it out. But I don't know. We could have a pillar coming down here. Just a dirty old pillar. And you can just add shapes to it. This is the beauty of it. You can just maybe put something there. It doesn't matter. I want something across here. So there we go. Right. Okay. So let's do these pillars. We're going to do them at the same time. So we're going to need some stone brick stairs as well. That. Some oak wood. Yes, definitely going to need some oak planks. Spruce, some of that. We'll need all the spruce stuff. Oak, sorry. Okay, let's do this. So starting from this bottom one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Up to here. In fact, could we? No, we'll do it at the top. Okay, so we're going to bring this up to 6 altogether. So from this ground, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we're just going to make these square marks. Now, I'm going to do it for both sides. So I'll do this side and then speed the other side up, copying the same thing. Just save us time. Best doing them at the same time as well, so you don't get mixed up. But I suppose you're following a tutorial, so it doesn't matter. So I'm going to speed this side up. Okay, so once you've done that, we should have this. And I'm going to use some of the cobblestone again to add that detail in. So on the inside, we're going to run it round. And I'll speed it up for the other side as well. So get that. And just fill this whole wall in. I think we'll actually make a window there as well. So we'll fill all that in and then plop our two window. We're going to work with that. We're going to put these ovals here. Keep it a simple one for that one. So I'm going to speed it up for this and this side. It's just exactly the same. So you're just following this. So going all the way around and making sure you've got a two window with the oval. So I'll speed it up. Okay, so once you're done, you should have something like this. What we're going to do for each part, we're going to count 1, 2, and then we're going to put a stair on top of each one, put a stair across here. And then in this bit, we're going to put in the corners, we're going to put one and just one diagonal each. So 1, 2, 1, 2. Obviously, we can't do the stairs out at this bit because it's going to be affected by that. 1, 2, so I'll do it for this side and then speed it up for the other side. So 1, 2, 1, 2, like that. For this side, we don't have to do it. We can put it up by one, sorry. Just making sure they're all kind of the same. Have these facing like that. This corner here as well. We can do that corner. We can do this corner. It's okay. Let's kind of have a look at that. That's nice. Right, yeah, so I'm going to speed it up and do it for the other side. And also, we're going to put this corner out like this in each corner. So we're going to have them both facing out. Like that, like that. Right, so I'm going to speed it up for the other side. Right, so as you can see, we've got both sides done. What I'm going to do here is leave this opening gap here that we can go through to here. We'll actually fill this bit in here with the oak so we can get past onto this castle wall bit. So otherwise we won't be able to get onto this bit. So these are kind of like archer defense towers. Only way up them is from the inside. So obviously you can't get people that have breached this bit and take the archer tower. They have to actually get within the compound, which is well thought out. I don't know, I'm just making this stuff up, but it sounds good, doesn't it? It sounds proper legit. Yeah, they have to infiltrate the inside. Take it from the inside and then infiltrate past the guard tower, majiggy thing, and take it all over. Yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to do for this bit, obviously we put 5 across here, as you can see, while I was chatting away. Just 5 slabs underneath here. If you want to, you can just put like a thing on each side. I just think it gives it a little bit more detail. So this either side, and then just put your slabs in. So just pause the video, get that bit done. I'm gonna quickly speed it up for the other side. Okay, let's do this, man. Right, so we're gonna count 1, 2, 3. For these bits here, I'm tempted just to put 2 blocks there. 1, 2, 3. 2 blocks maybe, or maybe it's a full, I don't know. We could have these as full. 1, 2, 3. We'll see how it looks. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. So we're gonna go up by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 maybe. I want to do it as 5 so we can actually put this underneath and then fill the rest in with log. The white wool. Sorry, I'm getting tired. I've done this for hours, man. This is hours. That across there. Yeah, we'll bring these up because we can actually get a side window, which is kind of, I don't know. We'll work something out. Work something out. So this up to here and then fill these bits in here. I wish you could hear this epic music that I'm listening to, but I'd probably get copyrighted, which is not a good thing. Let's put this in. This to the top. We want these facing up. We don't want them sticking out because you'll see it. Okay, so we've got that bit in, that bit in. Right, let's fill it with the wool, and now I'm going to speed it up for the other side. Right, so once we've done that, what I've done for this bit, these corners, I've just taken it out and then just put like a half slab underneath each one and on top. As you can see, going all the way around for each one. Then we're going to face these out. 1, 2, 3. Let's check for this bit, see what it'll look like. Like that, and then maybe just the one in there, or maybe something else. Maybe a full block and then 2 out. Yeah, can deal with that. And then it kind of emphasizes on this roof bit. So 2 out like this, and then we'll have our blocks coming out like that. Perfect. Right, so I'm going to go all the way around. So like this, either side. 1, 2, 3 out either side of these. 1, 2, 3. So I'll speed it up for the other one. But yeah, for here, full block and then 2 either side. We can actually put one in between each one of those as well. There we go. And then in between this bit here, this bit here. And I kind of, what I want to do here is put this out 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. And then we can add some more depth doing this way. So just keep note, because we're going to speed it up for the other side, we're going to actually put 3 there as well. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3. And then we're going to grab our spruce, as we have before, and take this up, maybe at this side, and this side as well, just for those archways. Because you've got like an archer tower at the top we're going to have, and these windows here, you could get people on the lower walls, which would be ideal. And I'm pretty sure they would have had it like this. They would have had like other windows where you can fire from, not just the very top of the towers. So I'm going to speed it up for the other one. Yeah, I've got that. That's all in. If you want to, you can add some more windows here. Which I might do actually, because it'll cut up on that white. We kind of just want something. I don't know. You probably wouldn't have windows. It'd have something like this. Maybe. We can do that. We can take them out. So I'll speed it up for the other one. Hopefully you followed along with this one. If you didn't, just go back, rewind, and do it again. All right, let's do this one. Right, so now what we are going to do, we're going to start from here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with the stairs. We're going to have a stair there and a stair there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stair facing in and in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stair facing in and in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stair facing in and in, and yeah, we're going to bring this up by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then one in the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So let's have a look on the outside. Might bring it up by 8. And yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So bring these all up by 8, and then we're gonna go across the top here. And join that there. This is gonna be kind of a solid wall, but we're obviously got some depth within this wall. It's going all the way across. So we're gonna repeat it the same on the other side. You just gotta keep on there. If you're working on two things, I always build it in parts and then go on to the next one. For here, we're going to have the solid stone brick in the corners. Yeah, it's better because if you do it bit by bit, if you do a whole thing and it's quite detailed, you end up being lost. And you're like, oh, what do I do for that bit? And what do I do for that bit? It gets quite complex. So yeah, to eradicate that. So I'm going to speed it up. Okay, so we should have both sides done. So what we're going to do is, on top of all these oak logs, we're just going to place one slab. So we're going to do the same for the other side. I'll speed it up for the other side as well. Okay, so once we've done that, we should have it at both sides. What we're going to do is we're going to put this underneath. In fact, on the inside, we'll do, we'll do these stairs underneath. And then on the outside, going to put a stair on each one. So I'll speed it up for the other one and this little bit here. Okay, so once you've done that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this like that, and then the same for the other side, just all the way around. We're going to repeat this pattern, so I'll speed it up. Okay, so we should have that at both sides. What we're going to do at the bottom of these and at the top, we're going to fill it in with the slab. So I'll speed it up for both sides. So we're going like this all the way around, and we're going to do it on that one as well. Okay, so once we've filled that in, we can either fill it in with this, or we can fill it in with the cobblestone wall. Now I'm going to fill it in with the cobblestone wall, I think, and keep this kind of plain. Let's see what that looks like. Yeah, that's all right. So I'm going to fill in all these bits with the cobblestone wall for this bit and this bit, going all the way around. So I'll speed this up as well. Okay, once we've done that, we are going to go in this corner and aim it up like this, and then we are going to get the oak, bring it up to this point, count 1, 2, and then we're just going to put a stair on either side. In fact, we'll just do the 1. I want to see what this looks like. Yeah, we'll just do the 1. So it'd be down either side, put the 1 on top. Oh no, wait, sorry. No. It's going to be downwards. Sorry, down and then up and then 1 on top. With this. So I'll speed it up for every single corner on both. Okay, so now once we've done that, we're going to count out 1, 2, 3. We're going to place a block on top here. And then we're going to do the same for each bit. So I'm going to speed it up each one on both sides. A block on top here as well. Oh yeah, and we'll put a cobblestone wall on top of each one. So I'll speed this up. Okay, so once we've done that, we're going to place this in between. I'm going to put this here, this in between. So we're going to do the same for the other one as well. So I'll speed up for the second one. So just half slab going all the way around. Okay, so once you've done that, we're going to place this in, and then we're going to put a cobblestone wall on each one. So there, cobblestone wall. And we're going to do the same for the other one. In each corner, cobblestone wall on top of each one. And then we can start to build the roof. So I'll speed it up for this. Okay, so once we've got these towers, now we are going to start on the magic, the roof. So we're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 across here. 1 on each one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1 on each one. Right, so I'm kind of just planning this in my head as we go. So hopefully it turns out okay. We've got a nice little guard tower bit where we can look out here. I mean, if you want to, you can add an extra bit here. But it's not necessary. We can actually put some railings here instead. Let's see how this will look. And I kind of want to do something for those bits as well. Yeah, so for these bits underneath here, just to kind of give it more circular motions. So I'll speed it up for the other one over here. Okay, so once we've done that, we are going to start on doing this bit, which is, we'll put another panel across here. It should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh no, that doesn't need an extra one. And then 1, 2, 3 here. No. 1, 2, 3. And then for this bit, in each corner, we're going to place 1. And then we're going to go up by 1 in each corner. So that's 1, 2, 3. Up in each corner. As you can see there. So I'll speed it up for the next one. In fact, we can actually add some extra on the outside as well. Let's see. Yeah, like that. Okay, so once we've done that, we can work on actually mounting the roof up a little bit more now. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. And then we'll have 1 diagonal in the corner of this. And we're going to slowly, I think it's going to be quite a tall one. I'm not sure. I might keep these basic. So we'll do the same. Speed up. Okay, so once we've done that, both sides, we're going to go like this. We're going to count 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1. 1, 2, 3. You guessed it. 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay. Have a look what it looks like. Yeah, that's fine. So I'll do the same for this one. Okay, so once we've done that, we're going to go diagonal, by one in each corner, like that. And then we are going to cover this and make a kind of X on top. So do the same for the other side, speed it up. Okay, so now we've done that, we're going to place it up at an extra 2 high for this bit. And then 1, 2, 3. I'm going to do the same on the other side. Okay, time to add some detail in now. So we're going to place one on here, one on here, one on here, and one facing out there. So do the same, one, 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 one facing out. One, 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 one facing out at the top here. One there, one on top of the three, another one on top of the three, one there. So I'll speed it up for the other side. Should have something shaped like that. Okay, so now we've done that, we can start adding some half slabs in. So we'll put a half slab across here. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. So we're starting at the bit where we've got our first thing there. And then, yeah, speed it up for the other one. Yeah, so once you've done that, it should look like this. Make sure you've got these bits. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Then 1, 2, 3. Then it'll go 1, 2, and then a full block. For this bit, we can go like this. And then we can add this. Beautiful. So you can just replace that one, put that in there, and then you just want one either side, one on top. As you can see there. So I'll repeat it, and then I'll do it for every single other one. So one block there, one either side, one on top. Okay, so once we've got that shape, we should have 1, 2, 3 there. And I kind of want to misplace this one here, this half slab, just to kind of round off that roof a little bit better. And then we take out, we've got our first stair that was there. On our second stair that's here, we're going to take out these either side of it and round these off. So it's like facing in, facing in, facing in, facing in. Now let's see, so it should look like that. And it's just so we can get some light coming through there. And then this one on top, we're going to place stair facing out on each one. And then we are going to put a half slab, maybe even a full, no, half on top of here. So I'll speed it up for the next one. Right, so once we've done that, what we are going to do is we're going to take out, so that one's there, we're going to take out this here and place a block in there. So just above that first stair, take out that block, place one in. And I'm going to speed it up for the next one. And then we can start adding a little bit more detail. I'm going to actually put a full block one here, which I did the half one. And we are going to place one of these on here, a cobblestone with a spruce on top. In fact, just up to the two, like that. There we go. So doing that bit, and then we're doing that. Right, I messed up on one of mine, so double check it. Right, so you've got this bit here where you've got these turny bits, and then I had another stair on top on one of them, on the other one I didn't, and then you've got the full block. Just a full block there. So that would only leave space for one of these and then one on top. So should look like that. Okay, so for the top here, we're obviously gonna have another one going like this, one on top, have one going all the way around, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 with this on top, and then we can work on the flakes. Right, okay, you should have both towers done, and that's looking fantastic. I kind of like that. You can obviously make your floor and stuff. You can get some stuff in there. You can actually make this. We're going to have like this level here. And then we're going to have another level. And we're going to have like maybe a pole going all the way through. Just to kind of divide it. We want it dead center. So find the center. Go down. And then we're going to have another floor at this level. Which we can actually just use slab for that. Use slab at this level. So we've still got the detail underneath, which is vital. More detail, the better. So fill this all in, making sure we've got the dead center, which we're going to have maybe this just running all the way through that we can kind of use. Now let's see. Get that going all the way up into the top. It should be in the dead center of the top. We can do that at the other tower as well. But for now, I'm just going to leave this one. Making sure you've got enough room to get a ladder up there, obviously, to get down. Next level would be this level, so you can just look out. You could even have it at this level. Right, okay, for this small one, I've just decided to just do 1, 2. I'm not the best at flags. We go diagonal out, 1, 2, and then 1, and then 1 diagonal. Just a tiny one. For the big one, I've chose this one. I mean, if you've got any better flag designs, you're more than welcome to try them out. Try that underneath here. I don't know, something like this. You know? I kind of like it like that. So, basically you want them all flying the same way because obviously the wind would be blowing them like that. So for this one, you just repeat the other side. So 1, 2, 3 down, and then we're going to go diagonal back out. 1, 2, 3, we're going to do 2 lots of this one. And then we're going to go diagonal out forwards again. So 1, 2, 3, and then we can count 1, 2 on top of this one. We're going to go back again. 1, 2, and then we're gonna go diagonal back in, 1, 2 out, and then 1 out like this, and you should have a flag flying beautifully like that. I think they're both the same. Yeah, so that is the flags. That's the flag sorted. I think they look pretty beast from a distance and from down here as well. That's pretty nice. Right, so let's work on some of the courtyard. So the courtyard, I'm going to speed this up. I'm going to have this area here. I'm wanting to do more here because... put another one here because we're going to have a horse stable here, I think. So we'll have another area maybe. Put 2 across there. We can have this bit where you can come in, right? Have this bit across here. You can kind of get underneath from the stairs and see them in here. I kind of want it as a horse stable. For this bit here, we can have like a little trough for the feeding of the horses. Feed them there, and I kind of want this bit covered up as well. Can have this up to here, and one coming down from here. Fill this in near the staircase. And then we can have this. We want a 2 area of the gates to get the horses through, because otherwise you can't get the horses through. At the back here, we can have some bales of hay and stuff. We can actually get some trapdoors where we can have the hay resting on. But right, I'll put some, get some hay out. We'll plant this. Have some against the wall here. I mean, it can be tidy, it can be messy, however you like. And put this across here. And then another rack of hay. You can have them facing different ways and stuff. If you want them facing up that way and stuff like that. And let's see. You can just have like little bits here and there, you know. So that's stacked up. We've got the horses in there. And we can have, obviously, some scattered around on the floor, up and down. Just have, like, different areas, you know. If you wanted more feeding areas, you're more than welcome to put some more around here. And, let's see, you can just have, like, a little gatepost going up here. Just kind of randomize it, you know. Let's get this coming up here, maybe coming across to give it a little bit more detail in there. And we can have some gateways coming across the top here. Make it look nice and horse-like, stable-like. And we can even have some hay out here, you know. Get an anvil or something. Get an anvil here. And yeah, that's gonna, I'm gonna have this as an arena where you fight, and that's the room where you eat. I think I'll definitely do it in another tutorial. We'll add some horses in here, and I'm definitely gonna do the ground in cobblestone, andesite, stone, and we can add some gravel in there as well. So I'm gonna do that for all this round here. You can even add more in where you take bricks out and stuff. Across the bottom of this, as you're just coming in, you could just do something plain like that. So I'm going to speed this up and fill all this. So as you can see, I've just added bits of grass as well. So if you just randomize it, get some grass on there, you can add some flowers as well. But as you can see, the floor's just all kind of mixed and matched all the way up to there. We've got a place for the horses. You can even have bits of, you can get the stairs as well. Whereabouts are you? Get the stairs and, you know, like take bits out that are kind of, misplaced, mixed and matched as you're coming through, just to kind of give it more depth. And I'll work on this bit after, probably. But yeah, we just want to add some detail to the walls and stuff outside here. I kind of wanted to do it as a marketplace, so we can get this going across here. We could have maybe just one way in, which would be something like this. We could have like little stalls and stuff. Get a little gate post there. You can divide them up so they have individual stalls and you have to walk for each one or something. Like there. Get this across. We're going to do the same at the other side as well. So I'll speed this up and then show you after. Right, just a little example, like this could be like fresh fruits, a fish market, meat market, maybe some chests selling something like melons, some dead plants or whatever. The other side, I've done stuff like this one's blank. You can do however you like, maybe some cooking, some more things, brewing stands, ender chest, you know, like mix it up a little bit. And yeah, you want to add some vines and stuff, you know, maybe like get some vines coming down, mess it up, get some kind of bush area, where it's kind of like riding up depending on how messy you kind of want it. So like this is kind of like an overgrown area. You can take bits out of the build. This is kind of like shaping the build now and adding your own little bit to it. So we can have cracked stone brick, we can have this, we can even have bits out of the wall here, you know, just kind of bits like that. And it's mostly on the bare bits of the wall, so you can have it just where it's like nice and clean. You can have a clean looking kind of bush going around like it's been trimmed, but like keep the wall messy, you know, just kind of crack it out wherever you like. Maybe you want some down the bottom, maybe these corners would be more dirty, just kind of make giving it that rustic feel. You can even keep it where it's cracked out here, and you know, little bits here, we want something out there or something. Can keep that there, you know, just keep on adding to it, add a bit more detail to it. You can even add some crap brick within these bits as well, you know, mix it up a little bit. You can get some dirty blocks, some moss there, and even down here on these walls as well, just kind of mixing it up, making it messy. It's just however you want it. If you want a kind of a rustic sort of look, kind of like pulling bits out here, and it's beautiful. So I'm going to call it a day on that one. Maybe get some crack bricks and stuff in some of these just to kind of mess it up a little bit. If you did enjoy this and you want the second part as well, definitely you have to slap that like button. I've spent so long doing this for you guys, and it makes it all worthwhile if you do help me out by just slapping that like button for all the hard work, you know. Really do appreciate it. Really hope you guys enjoy it. Hopefully it's something original from everybody else's medieval stuff online, and yeah, I shall catch you in the next video. And to all my new subscribers, thank you so much for subscribing, and all you people who've stuck around me for a long time. So, really do appreciate you guys. Here is your medieval barracks. Beautiful. Peace. I've got a rebel soul.